Give away another. Stop at $25. Stop at
Today, these three players are after high stakes, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter Demakis.
Thanks, everybody, and hi, everybody. Welcome once again to another edition of Press Your Luck, where the players are looking for very serious dollars and hoping to stay away from the very serious whammy and his bride-to-be, or maybe, we can't talk about it in great length, Tammy Wynette. So be very careful about the whammy, you know what I mean? Let's meet the players right now and find out a little bit more about them, starting with our first player, Brenda Scott. How are you,
Yay!
Brenda? Now, Brenda, I'm supposed to ask you about yourself and your husband?
Yes, my name is Brittany Scott. I'm from Long Beach, California. I've been with my husband 15 years. I have two kids by one is Farrah and Alexandra. They're 7 and 3, and I've only been married to them a year.
7 years. Okay. Brenda, okay. Welcome to the show, and
you want
to make some big bucks, right?
Right.
All right. Our second player is Bruce Fisher. How are you, Bruce?
All right, fine.
Bruce, I detect a slight accent here. Where are you from?
I'm from the heart of Texas, Waco is affectionately known. Waco, Texas.
Waco, Texas. I have some friends down in Waco, Texas. Nice place.
Right.
Now, did you move out here or you live there now?
I'm here on vacation, lay on the beach and get some big bucks.
I got you. Take it back to Waco and spend it.
Yeah.
All right, Bruce, best of luck to you.
Thanks a lot.
All right. And our third player, Paula Jo Gildella. How are you, Paula Jo?
Fine, thanks, Peter.
Good. Now, you are from where?
I'm from Pittsburgh, really Moon Township.
Oh, and you're out here since when?
Since Thursday.
Oh, well, only short. You going to stay here or it depends on the show?
Depends on the show and staying here. Both.
both. But you're looking for big bucks, nevertheless.
Yes, big bucks.
All right, look no further. You have come to the right place. We have the questions. You have the answers. A multiple choice answer, one spin. A buzzing answer gets you three spins. And those spins goes towards rolling the big board for the big bucks. Are you ready? Here we go.
Ready.
According to a new study from Princeton, a girl's chance of finding a husband begins to get real bleak if she hasn't married by what age? Paula Jo?
25.
Is the correct answer 25, 30, or 35? Brenda?
25.
25. Bruce?
I'll differ and say 30.
Well, Princeton says the chances narrow way down after the age of 25. Brenda gets a spin, and so does Paula Jo buzzing, so she gets three. What hit TV series is set on a ranch called South Fork? Brenda?
Dallas!
Is the correct answer Dallas? Falcon Crest? Or Dynasty, Bruce?
Dallas.
Paula Jo.
It's Dallas.
You got it. It's Dallas. Brenda, buzz in goes to four. Bruce gets a spin. And Paula Jo goes to four. Third question. According to People magazine, if you are an average guy or you know one, at what age can you count on seeing permanent wrinkle lines appear on your forehead, Bruce?
35.
Is the correct answer 35, 30, or 40, Brenda?
40.
40. What do you think, Paula Jo?
I'm going to say 30.
30. Well, the depressing news is that forehead wrinkles start at the age of 30. Oh. Not me. I'm only 22. That means Paula Jo goes to six, or to five, sorry, and we go to the last question. I don't have any wrinkles, do I? Just pull it back. Keep pulling it back. Here we go. Although people are always imitating him, what actor never said Judy, Judy, Judy in a film? Paula Jo.
Gary Cooper?
Is the correct answer Gary Cooper, Clark Gable, or Cary Grant? What do you think, Brenda?
Clark Gable.
What do you think, Bruce?
I think it's Cary Grant.
You think it's Cary Grant? Well, the actor who never said Judy, Judy, Judy. That was pretty good. It's Cary Grant.
Right.
And that means Brenda stays at four, Bruce goes at two, and Paula Jo stays at five. In a minute, we're going to get a chance to convert those spins into big buckaroos, so hang in there, folks. We're coming right back after this. 15,000 cash up there, some goodies and also some whammies, which are not goodies, in case you didn't know. The player who ends this round with the most money is going to play last in the final round, and that's where you want to wind up being, okay? You can pass your remaining spins anytime during your turn. If you have a fear of the whammy, four whammies will put you out of the game. Player with the fewest spins is first. Bruce, two of them. Here we go. Waco, Texas, looking out.
This is for me. No whammies, no whammies. Come on, big bucks, and stop.
Stop at $100 and a spin. Still have a few spins, $100. Gonna keep going.
Press my luck, baby. All right. Come on, big bucks. This is for my nephew. Stop.
Stop at advanced two spaces of $750. All right. Bruce. It's 5-0, and you still have one more spin.
I'm gonna take it, Peter.
Do it.
Come on, big bucks. Big bucks. This is for my mom. Stop.
Stop at $300. $11.50. Bruce, first place for now. All right, let's see what Brenda can do with four spins. Here we go, Brenda.
Come on, big bucks, no whammies. Big bucks, stop.
Stop at the balance chairs. Balance chairs, and those are worth $390. And
it goes up the rug. Come on, I need some money. Come on, big bucks. Come on for Long Beach. Stop.
Stop at $550, Brenda. Brings you up to 940. Second place, two spins. Pressure luck or pass.
Come on,
two tens.
Big bucks. I'm going to play, Peter. Big bucks. No whammies. No whammies. No whammies. Stop.
Stop at 500 more. Brenda, 1440. First place, one spin. What are you going to do?
Come on.
Come on. Brenda's going for it.
No whammies. No whammies. Come on, big bucks. Stop.
Stop at 0. Brenda, no fun, no dollars, only one whammy, no more spins. The game is far from over. We go to Paula Joe with five spins. Okay, Paula Joe, let's see what you can do.
Come on, no whammies. Keep the whammies in California and stop.
Stop at $100 and a spin. Still have your five spins, $100. Paula Joe, press your luck to pass. Second
press
place.
Press my luck. Okay, this is for my mom, dad, and sister Mara. Stop.
Stop at 12.50. 13.50, four spins, first place. Buy $200. What do you want to do, Paula Joe?
If I pass, they go to Bruce.
Go to Bruce. Play with the highest amount of money.
I'm going to press my luck,
Peter.
Here
we go.
Come on. This one's for the big old Steelers. And stop.
Stop at $300. Right. 16.50, three spins, 500 more than Bruce. Press your luck or pass.
I'm going to press my luck.
All right. Here we go.
Hey, Joyce and Allison and Mary. Let's go. No whammy. Stop.
Stop at a reclining rocker. That has a value of $329, Paula Joe. 1979, a good year, two spins, first place.
That's about 800 more than he has.
You have about $829 more than Bruce.
I'm gonna go one more time,
Peter.
Time,
one more time, says, here we go.
Peter.
Come on, this is for the First Baptist Church. No whammies, stop!
Stop it all. Paula Joe, $0, one whammy, one spin. You want to do it again?
I'm going to go.
All right, looking for first place.
Peter.
Bruce has got it right now. Let's see if it pulls away.
Mega Bucks, let's go. No whammies, and stop.
Stop at Electric Typewriter, Paula Joe. That's valued at $500. Brenda, $0. Paula Joe, $5. And Bruce, at $11.50, you have first place and the advantage. We're coming right back after this with a whole new round of questions and answers. So stay with us. Don't go away, Waco. I got the questions, you give me the answers, you'll get the spins. Here we go. Way back in the 50s, what sport did Burt Reynolds play for Florida? Bruce.
Football.
For Florida State University. Is the correct answer football, basketball, or baseball, Brenda?
I'll agree, football.
Football. What do
I'll
you think,
football.
Paul? Yeah, Florida State. Burt was on the football team. Brenda gets a spin. Bruce Buzzin gets three. Paula Joe gets a spin. Here we go to number two. A Ford, a Cadillac, or a Chevrolet? Which of those cars had a model nicknamed the Tin Lizzy? Bruce?
Ford.
Is the correct answer Ford, Cadillac, or Chevrolet? Brenda?
Could you repeat the question again?
Sure. A Ford, a Cadillac, or a Chevrolet? Which of those cars had a model nicknamed the Tin Lizzy?
I'll go with the Cadillac.
Cadillac. What do you think,
Paula? I'm going to say the Ford.
Well, the Tin Lizzy was made by Ford.
Yeah.
Bruce goes to six. Paula Joe to two. Go with the third question. Woody Herman had his herd. Fred Waring had the Pennsylvanians. What famous musician heads up the Tijuana Brass? Paul and Joe.
Herb Alpert.
Is the correct answer Herb Alpert, Trini Lopez, or Don Ho? Brenda?
I agree, Herb Alpert.
Herb Alpert. What do you think, Bruce?
I think it's Herb Alpert.
Yeah, the top of the Tijuana brass is Herb Alpert. Brenda goes to 2, Bruce to 6, 7, sorry. Paul and Joe buzzing goes to 5. Don Ho, the Tijuana brass. Tiny boy. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. All right, we're going to go to the last question. Wherever it is, here it is. You're lucky. Someone who likes you a lot just gave you a beautiful sapphire ring to match your sapphire-colored car. What color is the stone, Paula Jo?
Blue.
Is the correct answer blue, red, or green? Brenda?
Blue.
Blue. What do you think, Bruce?
Blue.
Yeah, the sapphire color is blue, of course. Brenda goes to 3, Bruce to 8. And Paula Jo to 8. And you're going to get a chance to take all those spins for the big board and walk away with a big buck. Brenda, stay with us.